We'll see some common terms that are used in royalty. First, let us understand what is minimum rent. Okay, minimum rent. This minimum rent is also otherwise known as dead rent. So let's understand this. If you take royalty, generally what will happen is the royalty will be linked. The royalty that is payable to the owner will be linked with the quantum that is produced from the given asset or the quantum that is sold. But there is a problem with this linking. Let's say at some point of time that if user of the asset is not able to produce as expected, or if he is not in a position to sell as expected, so his revenue will be lesser. And if royalty is linked with any of these, then automatically royalty payable to the owner of the asset will also be lesser. So because of this linking, what will happen is owner is going to get lesser revenue, and this is because of inefficiency of the user. That is, if the user had made best use of the resources or best use of all his abilities, he could have sold the product in the market, but he couldn't do it. So because of that, who is going to suffer now? The owner also. So it will result in lesser revenue for the owner. So that kind of scenario should not happen. So there is a clause for minimum rent. Okay, so this minimum rent will operate such that the rent will be calculated on two bases. Okay, the rent will be calculated on two bases. Let me give the calculation. First, the royalty calculated by, royalty will be calculated by linking with the production or sales. Okay, so royalty will be calculated by linking with production or sales. Then the minimum rent will also be given. So now, whichever is higher, that will be paid as royalty. So first, royalty will be calculated by linking with production or sales depending upon the terms. Then minimum rent will also be taken. So whichever is higher, that will be considered as royalty. For example, we'll take an example. Let's say royalty is something like rupees 10 per ton sold, or let's say produced. Okay, 10 per ton produced, and number of tons produced, let me give it, number of tons produced is something like say 10,000 units or 10,000 tons. So in that case, what should be the royalty? It is going to be 10,000 multiplied by 10, which should be 1 lakh. So that should be the royalty, if it is linked with the number of tons produced. But at the same time, there is also minimum royalty or minimum rent, and minimum rent is 1,50,000. So now minimum rent is 1,50,000, whereas royalty calculated on the basis of number of tons produced is 1 lakh. So the payment should be, whichever is higher, payment should be 1,50,000, right? So that's minimum rent. And here the royalty is paid on the basis of whichever is higher. On the contrary, let's say the figure works out like this. It is 20 per ton, not 10 per ton. Let me modify here. It's going to be 20 per ton. In that case, 10,000 into 20, which is going to be 2 lakhs. And what is the minimum rent? 1,50,000. Now, what will be the royalty payment? The royalty payment will be, whichever is higher, it will be 2 lakhs. So I hope you got the point. Okay, so if a contract has been entered into for payment of royalty, generally they'll be calculated by linking them with the quantum that is produced or sold at a certain stipulated rate. But in the period where there is no production or sale, the landlord will receive little or no royalty, and this is because of inefficiency of the user. To avoid such kind of situation, the landlord and lessee will agree for minimum periodical amount, and landlord will receive from lessee even if actual royalty calculated is lesser than the minimum amount. Okay, so this minimum rent is also otherwise known as dead rent, or certain rent, or fixed rent.